Why the big surge now? Obviously, in terms of your percent, way more than anybody else. Why now?
Well, our message is hitting home, Aaron. Americans realize that we need to think bigger about solutions. We're in the greatest economic transformation in our country's history, and it's not immigrants that are causing these problems, it's automation and advanced technologies. If we distribute the gains from these technologies and innovations into our hands, then we can improve our way of life very, very quickly.
So you're looking at $10 million. Look, it's a lot of money by any measure. And the context, though, of course, is what you're up against. And I'm not even talking in terms of your own party. I'm talking about Trump and the RNC. They say they've raised $125 million in the same quarter. I mean, that's a huge number. The president has passionate donors. Are you worried about the strength that this shows for him, even in the midst of what he's going through right now in Washington? $125 million.
I think right now you have a fragmented Democratic field, but when we come together behind a nominee, that nominee is going to have ample resources to take on and defeat Donald Trump in the general election. And even now, I'm one of only two candidates in the Democratic field that 10% or more of Donald Trump voters said they would support in the general, which I think makes me the strongest candidate to take him on next fall.
So Trump today tweeted, just in part, the word bull expletive. He put it in all caps in the middle of a tweet talking about Democrats. Your rival, Kamala Harris, Senator Harris, wrote a letter to the Twitter CEO, Jack Dorsey, and she actually pointed to six other tweets. She says they all violate Twitter's rules of conduct. She says the president uses his account to, quote, target, harass, and attempt to out the whistleblower, suggesting that violence could be incited should Congress issue formal articles of impeachment against him. You have a groundswell of support on social media. Is Senator Harris right that President Trump should be silenced?
Well, I think that there was a stronger case for him not being able to use some of these platforms before he was the president of the United States. And now that he's in office, it's much harder to say, look, he shouldn't have access to something like Twitter. But I'm friendly with some of these technology leaders, and they say at this point they want to work with the government to find appropriate standards, and they feel like it's tough for them to be in a position where they're making these kinds of decisions, including regarding Donald Trump's Twitter account.
Right. I mean, do you believe fundamentally that he's got the right of free speech, and he is the president of the United States? I mean, that he should be allowed to, whatever, however he's going to use it. In a sense, the rules, some of their codes of conduct may not apply.
Well, I think it's just a much, much harder case to make when you are talking about a political office holder, in this case, the President of the United States, that you're going to be able to kick him off of one of these platforms. Because at this point, he is a major, major public figure, and saying that he's not allowed to use a particular service is very difficult.
So let me ask you today, I'm sure you saw this earlier this week. The editorial board at the USA Today came out against your freedom dividend plan, and they conclude, their final sentence was, Andrew Yang's freedom dividend is one of those too good to be true proposals that are hard to take seriously. They go through your plan, and they say that you would give, for example, a young affluent couple $24,000 a year, right, 12,000 each, while a single mother of three would get only 12,000. What do you say to them?
Well, what I say is that the freedom dividends intended to be a foundation or a floor for all Americans, and that we can't stop there. If you do have a single mother of three, there are programs designed to help make it better for her and more fair for her, and that those programs continue to evolve, and that's where we should be investing. So the freedom dividend isn't meant to solve every problem for everyone, but it would make us stronger, healthier, mentally healthier, and give millions of Americans a leg up and a path forward in an evolving economy.
Before we go, I want to ask you about Bernie Sanders, obviously your rival for the nomination. The senator obviously just had a heart procedure for stents to be inserted in his arteries. He says he's taking time off the campaign trail to recover. What's your message to him?
Bernie, you're a national hero, a role model, an inspiration for so many of us, and you just need to get well. The country will still be here waiting for you when you get back on the trail, and I'm sure that'll be very soon.